हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ चमेली देवी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी इंदौर। नाउ हियर अगेन आई एम विद द टॉपिक फिल्ट्रेशन एंड क्लेरिफिकेशन, एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट फिल्टर एड्स। नाउ लेट्स सी द टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड। फर्स्ट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फिल्टर एड्स, देन आइडियल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फिल्टर एड्स and some types of filtrates. So these three topics we will cover in the session. Now first of all, let's see the definition. A filter aid is a finely divided material which when added to the liquid to be filtered and helps control flow and solid removal. So for the easy filtration, these filter aids are added into the liquid, so it will help for a better control flow and solid removal. And another definition is, it is an agent that consists of solid particles that improves filtering efficiency, and that is either added to the suspension to be filtered or placed on the filter as a layer through which the liquid must pass. So here these are the agents which are when added to the solid particles, it will improve the filtering efficiency, which means it will increase the permeability of the filter cake and help for the easy removal of the solids from the liquids. Now the another definition can also be stated like, it is a group of inert materials that can be used in filtration pre-treatment. So the filter aids can also be used in the filtration pre-treatment. So first is as a pre-coat. So it can be used as a pre-coat, which means it forms a layer of second medium that protects the basic medium of the system. So we can apply it as a pre-coat. And second is, it can act as an admix or body feed, which means by using an as a admix or body feed, it improves the flow rate by decreasing cake compressibility and increasing cake permeability. So filter aid can also be used in these two ways, like as a pre-coat and as an admix or body feed. So in this figure you can see the first figure shows that the filtration without filter aid, then second figure shows the filtration with pre-coat, and third figure shows the filtration with admix and pre-coat. So it is the another property of filter aids which can be used as in filtration pre-treatment. Now let's see the ideal properties of filter aids. Now first is, it should be chemically inert and light in weight. So the filter aid must be chemically inert, which means it is not chemically reactive, so that it will not react with our liquid. And after that, it should form a porous cake. So the filter aid must form a porous cake so that it will ease the filtration. Then it should be free from impurities. So the filter aid must be free from impurities so that we get a pure filtrate. Then it should be insoluble in liquids. So the suspension or liquid we are filtering, the filter aid must be insoluble in that liquid. Then it should be free from moisture. And the other important properties include, it should provide a thin layer of solids having highest porosity. Then it should give the desired flow rate and clarity. So the filter aid should give a desired flow rate of the suspension and should give a clear filtrate. Then it must consist of rigid complex shaped discrete particles. So the filtrate should be of discrete particles, and it can remove fine solids at flow rates. So the filtrate should be such that it can remove fine solids at highest flow rates. So these are the ideal properties of filtrates. Now let's see the various types of filtrates. First is diatomite, then perlite, cellulose, asbestos, and carbon. So these are the various types of filtrates that are used in the filtration. Now let's see the first filtrate. It is diatomite. Now diatomite is also known as diatomaceous earth. The chemical composition of the diatomite is 86% of silicon, 5% of sodium, 3% magnesium, and 2% iron. The advantages of diatomite is it forms a rigid and highly porous structure, and it also forms a non-compressible cake and acts as a sieve to remove fine solids, and it is also inert in nature. These are the advantages of diatomite. And the disadvantage is it may contaminate the process liquids. So the liquid we are using for filtration, it may contaminate the liquid. So this is all about the diatomite, its chemical composition, advantages and disadvantages. Now let's see another filtrate. Now the next filtrate is perlite. This perlite is made up of glass-like volcanic rock. It consists of small particles with cracks that retain water and gas. So the perlite is made up of volcanic rock, and its chemical composition is silicon dioxide, aluminum oxide, sodium oxide, potassium oxide, iron oxide, magnesium oxide, and calcium oxide. Now let's see the advantages. Now the perlite has low specific weight than diatomite. So due to this, it allows less filtrate to be used. And it is also relative pure than diatomite. So these are the advantages. And the disadvantage of perlite is it is more soluble. So when it is used with filtration process, then it can be soluble in some of the liquids, so we will get the impure filtrate. So it is more soluble, so this is the disadvantage of perlite. So these are the properties of perlite, its chemical composition, advantages and disadvantages. Now the next filtrate is cellulose. The chemical composition is cellulose. The advantage of cellulose are it is combustible, so which is important when for the recovery of valuable metals. Then it is compatible with hot caustic solutions. So when filtration of hot caustic solution is done, then at that time we can use cellulose as a filtrate. But diatomite and perlite, they are not compatible with hot caustic solutions. So during the hot caustic solution filtration, we can't use DE and perlite. And the disadvantage is it is expensive. So these are the properties of cellulose. Now next is the asbestos. The chemical composition is it is made up of aluminosilicate. Advantage is it retain good on coarse screen. So when a coarse screen or filter media is used, then it can retain good on coarse screen. So whenever that is a coarse screen as a filter media, you can use asbestos as a filter aid. and the disadvantage is it is more soluble. So we can get a traces of asbestos in the filtrate. So these are the properties of asbestos. And the last filtrate is carbon. The chemical composition is carbon, and the advantage is it does not react with strong alkalis. So whenever we are using strong alkalis for the filtration, then we can use carbon as a filtrate because it does not react with strong alkalis. For example, like sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide. Then the disadvantage are it is expensive. So these are the properties of carbon. So thank you guys. So in the today's session, we discussed about various properties of filtrates, that ideal properties that are required for filtrates, that its definition, and the various types of filtrates which can be used in the filtration process. Thank you.